It's spring.
One of my all-time favorite projects is Jumping PCB Frog. This concept started by having a coil that pushes two magnets up, but then I made a version that was completely wire-free. So it had to have all the electronics and battery on board, which obviously reduced its jumping height. This made the thing unpractical, but maybe I can make some mechanical modifications to the design to make it jump higher, which is what I'm planning to do in this video. For testing purposes, I'm going to stick with a one coil design, which is going to make things easier to test. My original first version managed to jump a height of 15 mm. My first idea was to make the arms thinner and more flexible. This can be done by removing the solder mask layer. I didn't want it to be too flexible, so I decided to make this braided pattern. These two changes should allow the magnet to move easier and faster through the air. I think this kind of flopped because there wasn't an actual improvement in the jump. I also noticed that at very low frequencies the magnets are getting twisted. It's jumping okay at 7 Hz, but I think the arms need to be more springy, which means more prototypes. Thank you PCB Way for sponsoring this flex panel, which has 50 samples. I decided to design out of different designs, which most of them were just copied and pasted on Altium Designer, but this way I can test different arm lengths with different stiffeners, hold coils and zigzag springy arms. Let's start with the length. I tested 4 different arm lengths. The 10 mm version didn't quite work as the coils couldn't attract the magnets at that length, but as the arms got longer, the PCB jumped higher. The best result was the 25 mm arm length, which managed to jump a maximum of 25 mm.
Well, the arm lengths are directly equal to the jumping height.
This time I also wanted to test stiffer arms, which I done by adding copper and plastic stiffeners. These were quite springy, but unfortunately the coil's magnetic field was not strong enough to attract the magnet. The copper sample worked a little bit better by applying a square wave, but it still wasn't an improvement. The samples with the hold coil also jumped a shorter height. My idea behind this test was to reduce the surface area of the bottom coil, which I still think helped a bit, but the missing copper turns reduced the coil's magnetic field, making it less powerful. My last hope was the Zigzag Pcb Spring. This was suggested by some of my viewers in the previous two videos. Its concept is that during the jump, it will help the coil reach the magnet quicker, which will then extend the jumping height. In version 2, I applied a similar concept with software, so I'm very curious to see what will happen with this Pcb Spring. So apparently instead of pushing the magnet, it's easier for it to just twist. The one with the copper stiffener managed to make some jumps, but the spring concept didn't really work. The plastic stiffener prototype had worse results, as the magnet was being held too firm. So from all these results, the best configuration is the 25 mm arm length. Another thing that could improve the jump is driving the coils with more power. We have to be very careful here because we don't want to overheat the thing, so we only can apply very short pulses. I'm not sure how well this can be integrated with the wire-free version because 2 LiPo cells would make the thing overweight and a boost converter would need a larger electronics area. On top of all these options, I have another solution, which is the 12-layer PCB coil. This would definitely give the best PCB jumping records, but the RoboFrog will no longer be made from one flexible PCB. So please let me know which of these options you'd love to see me build.